In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart. Oh, let
For our goodnight message on this Monday, the 22nd of November 2021, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. We'll listen to this inspiring message in line with the gospel passage of today entitled Lessons from the Widow of Jerusalem. Today we read from Luke chapter 21 verse 1 to 4. Jesus was looking up and seeing the rich putting their gifts into the offering box. And he saw a poor widow put in two small copper coins. And he praised that poor widow for having put in everything that she had. And if you ask me a question, what lessons can we draw from this event? Jesus is at the end of his life. He is about to give everything for humanity. He is about to give himself. And he uses that widow to tell us that that is exactly the giving he was going to do. Since she gave all that she had, Jesus was going to give all that he is for humanity. The other lesson we draw is that quality is more important than quantity. In terms of their spelling, quality and quantity look about the same, but in God's eyes, quality is more important than quantity. As you probably know, quantity has to do with the amount, whereas quality has to do with how good something is. In regards to the story of the widow's offering, the rich were putting more money into the temple's treasury in terms of quantity. But in terms of quality, the widow gave more. That's why Jesus said, "This poor widow has put in more than all the others." Luke chapter 21 verse 3. The other lesson we draw from this story is that standing out to people isn't always standing out to God. In the story of the widow's offering, there is a good chance that Jesus commented on what the widow gave compared to the rich people because the rich were attracting attention by what appeared to be significant gifts. But as you know, their gifts weren't as significant as the poor widow's might in the eyes of God. This is why another lesson to learn is standing out to people isn't always standing out to God. Similar to how we can sometimes get distracted by focusing on quantity rather than quality, we can get distracted by doing things that get people's attention at the expense of being recognized by God. This shouldn't be a big surprise. Jesus taught multiple lessons that highlight this. For example, when praying, Jesus said, "Do not be like the hypocrites. For they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on the street corners to be seen by others." Matthew chapter 6 verse 5. As for fasting, Jesus said, "Do not look somber as the hypocrites do, for they disfigure their faces to show others they are fasting." Matthew chapter 6 verse 16. When Samuel thought one of Jesse's sons was the next king because of how he looked, God disagreed, saying, "People look at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart." 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 7. The other lesson we learn from the poor widow is that you don't need to stand out to people. So, know that you don't necessarily need to stand out to God. In many situations like the poor widow, giving your best gets more attention from God, although it appears insignificant to people. be sure to fall in the category of those Jesus said during the judgment will wonder when they did good things for God, when it was the seemingly small things that they did for others. Matthew 25 verse 34 to 40. Because for some believers that are standing out, Jesus said, many will say, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name? And in your name drive out demons? And in your name perform many miracles? Matthew chapter 7 verse 22. But to them, his response will be, I never knew you. Away from me, you evildoers. Remember, do your best, whatever that looks like. People don't have to see it as big for it to be big in God's eyes. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as your dreams.
Same to you, Father.